Hey guys, welcome back to Genealogy and Chronology. Today we will be discussing about the complete genealogical history of the early Chalukya dynasty, which ruled over present-day Western Deccan region between 540 AD and 753 AD. This chart is part 7 of a 12-part series on the history of the Telangana project by Genealogy and Chronology. Additionally, this chart is part 3 of a 4-part series on the Chalukya dynasties of Deccan project by Genealogy and Chronology. Please consider subscribing to my channel as I will be discussing more about genealogies and history of Indian royal houses in coming weeks. The Chalukyas of Badami, more formally known as the early Chalukyas, ruled over much of present-day states of Telangana, Karnataka, Maharashtra and parts of Andhra Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Kerala and Tamilnadu between 543 AD and 753 AD. They previously served as feudatories to the Kadambas. The Chalukya dynasty was established by Pulakeshin I with Vatapi as capital, which is nowadays referred to as Badami. Pulakeshin rose to power after overthrowing the Kadambas and annexing remainder of the Vishnukundina dynasty provinces into his kingdom. At its peak, the Badami Chalukya Kingdom stretched from River Narmada in the north to River Kaveri in the south. Kubja Vishnuvardana, grandson of Pulakeshin I, would break away from the Badami Chalukya Kingdom when his elder brother was king and established the Vengi Chalukya dynasty. The rule of the Badami Chalukyas ended in 753 AD when Dantivarman II overthrew Kirtivarman II, the last king of the Badami Chalukyas, and established the Rashtrakuta dynasty. The Badami Chalukya princes served as feudatory chieftains under the Rashtrakutas for 6 generations. Tailapa II, a descendant of the Badami Chalukyas, overthrew the Rashtrakutas and established the Western Chalukya dynasty. Western Chalukyas ruled Western Deccan until 1200 AD, whereas the Eastern Chalukyas ruled Eastern Deccan until 1279 AD. Moving on to the family tree of the Badami Chalukyas, the first historical reference that we have about a Chalukya chief is around year 500 AD when Jayasimha served as feudatory chieftain of the Chalukyas under the Kadambas. Later around year 520, his son Ranaraga served as feudatory chieftain of the Chalukyas under the Kadamba rulers. During the year 540, Ranaraga's son Pulakeshin I succeeded him. He served briefly as a feudatory chieftain under the Kadamba rulers before declaring independence and establishing the Chalukya rule. After ruling for 26 years, Pulakeshin I was succeeded by his son Kirtivarman I in 566 AD. Kirtivarman annexed much of the remaining Kadamba territory into his kingdom and enjoyed a long reign of 31 years. In 597 AD, Kirtivarman I passed away and was succeeded by his brother Mangalesha. It is unclear if Mangalesha usurped the throne from his nephew or ruled as a regent while his nephew was still young. In the year 609 AD, Mangalesha was succeeded by his nephew Pulakeshin II, son of Kirtivarman I. In the early 600s, Pulakeshin II led many campaigns and brought much of the Deccan region under his control. In the year 624, Pulakeshin II's brother Kubja Vishnuvardana broke away from the Badami kingdom and established the Vengi Chalukya dynasty ruling over the present-day coastal Andhra region. Three of Pulakeshin's sons and three of Pulakeshin's grandsons would go on to become kings. In 642 AD, Pulakeshin II died and was succeeded by his son Aditya Varma. Aditya Varma had a short rule of only 3 years. In year 645 AD, Aditya Varma was succeeded by his son Abhinavaditya. He too had a short rule of only 1 year. In 646 AD, Abhinavaditya was succeeded by his uncle Chandraditya. Chandraditya would reign for only 3 years, just like his brother. In 649 AD, Chandraditya was succeeded by his minor son as king, while Chandraditya's wife Vijaya Bhattarika served as regent for her minor son. In 655 AD, Vikramaditya, another son of Pulakeshin II, declared himself king of the Chalukyas After reigning for 25 years, in the year 680 AD, Vikramaditya died and was succeeded by his son Vinayaditya. Vinayaditya ruled for 16 years and died in 696 AD and was succeeded by his son Vijayaditya. Vijayaditya was one of the most famous kings from the Badami Chalukya dynasty, briefly expanding the kingdom to its biggest extent. In 733 AD, after reigning for 37 years, Vijayaditya passed away and was succeeded by his son Vikramaditya II. The Badami Chalukyas declined after Vijayaditya's passing. Vikramaditya II died in 746 AD and was succeeded by his son Kirtivarman II, who would rule for only 7 years and also be the last king of the early Chalukya dynasty. In 753 AD, Kirtivarman II was overthrown by Rashtrakuta chieftain Dantivarman II, who served as feudatory chieftain under the Badami Chalukyas and established the Rashtrakuta Empire. The descendants of the Badami Chalukya royal house served as subordinates to the Rashtrakutas for 220 years, after which the Chalukya rule was revived by Ailappa II, who was the great-great-great-great-great-grandson of Vijayaditya, 11th king of the Badami Chalukyas. I hope you all like this complete overview of the royal house of the early Chalukya dynasty. Next month, I will release the family tree of the Vishnukundina dynasty chart, which is going to be part 8 of the 12-part series in the history of Telangana project. Later in the first week of July, I will release a complete overview of the early, western and eastern Chalukya dynasties chart. That chart will be the last part of the Chalukya dynasties of Deccan project by genealogy and chronology. You can watch the videos of the other 6 dynasties that ruled Telangana region after the early Chalukyas by clicking on the playlist on my channel. Please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel and sharing this video with your friends and family. If you want to buy a copy of this chart, please visit genealogyandchronology.com. If you like my work, please consider supporting me on Patreon by becoming a member, or you can buy me a coffee by scanning this QR code. Thank you.